So you see before this deck panel, this deck filler panel, I think its official name is. As I ground off these welds, because they're all little pinch welds from the factory, and it's easier just to kind of take a grinder and weld those thin, and then you take your cutter and just kind of hammer these out, and that leaves a little bit of metal left over here. This one up here was so rusty, it was pretty easy. I just pulled it right off. Luckily, as I came through and fixed this, this wasn't rusted all the way through. As you can see, I've taken a flapper disc and kind of cleaned this up, trying to get it back to bare metal, cleaning all this surface rust and dirt out of here. I'll come through and repaint all this just to kind of keep it nice and protected as I put the new one in there. I got to finish cutting these out here on the side of this. I don't know if you can see that. I kind of messed up. I cut too far in here. Hopefully I'll be able to re-weld all this before I mount the new deck filler. But anyway, that'll give me my nice new windowsill here. When I put the roof on, I'll have that top part, and then I should have no rust in the front or rear windows. So yesterday you saw we got some weld through primer on here. We got some protection put on here, some paint. Read a lot of stuff about POR. Maybe it's the best, maybe it's not. I don't know, but these things didn't have a lot of protection anyway, so it's better than what it was. Anyway, moving on today, it's all dry. I'm trying to get all this metal nice and flat, get this fitting right. As with any of these panels, there's going to be some massaging. This corner right here is not really fitting that great, so in and out a few times already. And I have to grind this corner off on here. It's just not sitting down all the way. So in and out a few more times, and hopefully this thing will be fitting and we'll get it welded in and be able to move to our next project. So we're able to do those last few adjustments in this corner. Got it fitting really good. This corner fits pretty good. Fits nice and tight. Like I said, I'm a fan of AMD. I think their stuff fits better than most of the stuff I've used. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go mark all my holes for my plug welds. Then I am going to pull this out, drill the holes. I'll get it in here, use the body clamps, get this clamp down, and we'll get it welded in. So our next step, putting this on, I'm gonna weld these rain gutters back together. I popped both these welds when I was pulling this out. So when you're doing this, when you're sizing these, make sure you have plenty of these body clamps. I have a lot of different sizes, a lot of different shapes, a lot of ends. There's so many of these, but you never know what you're gonna need. And these come in such handy when you're doing these, because they'll get, you have everything placed exactly where you want it before you start welding. So I've done this a few times with this Camaro. By no means am I an expert, but I've done it, put it together and taken it apart enough times that I know that these things are so important in fitting these where you need it to go. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to clamp these in, weld them, then I'm going to get that panel put in here. We'll get it placed, get it clamped in, then we'll start welding. Then we should be able to wrap this up today. Fingers crossed. I sucked this panel all the way down into this gutter. I mean, it's good here, it's just right here. It doesn't line up here at the body. So I use body clamps here and here to get the body line totally level. In my build, you've seen that I'm shaving all the body lines out, so this is really important for me. So I'll start put some tack welds in this. And then pull this down and weld it, and then I'll pull this down after this is tack welded in place. Because if I pull this down, it makes this panel about an eighth inch under the quarter panel here. So I want it as even as I can get it.